a general rule is 45,000 kilometres for a component before it goes racing, which is like three times a safety limit.
Welcome to our Crowdstrike safety series. Today, we've got the opportunity to find out a little bit more about the team's test and development department. This is where we test all the components that we manufacture for durability, reliability, and also setup. F1 is a constant compromise between optimizing the strength of a component whilst also making it as lightweight as possible. Pete, thank you so much for joining us today. In terms of the department, what would you say test and development's primary aim is, or its main objective?
Well, our main objective is to make sure the components pass the safety standards that are set and also pass the performance criteria that are set for the components.
Well, that's an interesting issue, isn't it? Because safety is obviously critical in Formula One. So how do you balance the needs of safety with that of performance?
Quite often, components would need to be a lot bigger and heavier to pass the loads that we put through them. So it's always a playoff between having components not too heavy that it slows the car down, but again, not too light that they fail and don't pass the tests.
Now, TNDD is essentially a laboratory environment. So how do we generate the vast forces that we need to best accurately simulate race conditions?
So TNDD has a hydraulic ring main which supplies the hydraulic rigs within the lab. We have five or six 100 kilonewton machines which can achieve 10 tons of load, and then we have a 600 kilonewton machine which can generate forces in the region of 60 tons.
Are we able to say what is the strongest part of an F1 car?
Well, the chassis has to pass a 300 kilonewton size squeeze FIA test at the start of the year. But component-wise, the front wishbone has to see 82 kilonewtons of load on a proof test, which is in the region of 8 tons, which for the size of it is very impressive.
Yeah, so for that strength to size ratio, that's incredible what it's able to achieve. You must do hundreds of tests all throughout the year. How do you keep track of all the data that you collect?
So we have a test request system where all the tests are saved and all the data is tracked. And we also have a lifing system where all the components have life numbers and part numbers, and mileage can be added to those parts, and also key milestones like fatigue testing and proof testing.
Yeah, in terms of mileage, what kind of distance are we testing the components to?
Well, a general rule is 45,000 kilometres for a component before it goes racing, which is like three times a safety limit, because car components wouldn't generally go beyond 15,000.
45,000 kilometres, that's what 150 race distances that it's tested to before it goes on the car. That's absolutely phenomenal. Do you have a busier time of year in the department?
Yes, it's definitely December and January and February. So the car designers want as long as possible to design the components, but then we need to allow for manufacturer build and then TNDD testing. With the first test date not moving, we've only got a certain amount of time to fit our tests in.
And then when the components have passed the safety test, they've been put onto the car, it's headed out for the first test. What happens for the rest of the year?
So we'll often do mileage accumulation, which push those parts up to our higher mileage. But also we may have a lightweighting program where the designer will remove mass from components, and then we'll have to start that testing process all over again.
And then over a race weekend, you know, as we travel around the globe, what are TNDD doing back home to support the race team?
Well, if there was ever a load case that was seen at the track, say on a Friday session, we may have to come in and put that load through a TNDD component to check that that part can survive the race weekend.
So everyone's working as well back at the factory and at the track. Pete, thank you so much for your time today. It's been fascinating to learn just how vital the work that TNDD do to help keep everyone safe.